Now we're here. We have been doing a few scatavs with all the boys, and right now we're actually just fine-tuning all the preparations for the last blue hole jump that is about to happen tomorrow, and to really clean up each individual's flying, and also get them ready to do a nice performance over the blue hole. So it's pretty exciting now to see the progression of everybody, and also to see the progression of Nick, which is quite amazing. How, like, from pretty much tracking belly to now starting the head down carving and stuff like this. I'm really looking forward to this jump where I'm going to join you, actually, and Nick for a good carving three-way.
You know what? The only thing I was sad about the jump is I could not see your face.
Oh my god, I was looking, you know your reaction? I was like,
what did you guys do?
Oh, I just make him like calm, and you're gonna see the video.
Okay.
We're just being flying.
Honestly,
basically,
man, I was like, oh my, I was looking in your eyes, and you were like, oh, 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 and I was like, oh my god.
Yeah, Nick.
What's up, guys?
I'm so happy to get a moment with you, because now our trip has come to an end. And I think it's time to introduce the main master behind all of this stuff. And that is you, Nick.
It is.
It is you. It is like, and the funny thing is, like, a couple of weeks ago, I'm gonna try and sit closer, because now we're on this selfie cam with a 12mm. It's not really that wide, but it doesn't really matter. But yeah, a couple of weeks ago when we got invited to this trip, I didn't know anything about the actual trip. I didn't know anything about Nick. I didn't know what the purpose of the trip was. And now, looking back at what we did the last 2 weeks, I'm extremely grateful. Like, deeply humbled.
Likewise,
and grateful, and so proud to be able to be a part of it. Because what Nick wants to create here is something much, much bigger in the long run. And I think, like, and this whole team UPRISING and this to create
a movement
and something that is very positive for everyone, you know, everyone in the team, everyone in the as humans and society in general, I think is really good. But to give you guys a little bit of a breakdown of who Nick is, maybe you should just tell a little bit about who you are.
Yeah, for sure. I will do. Like, I will start with recently my identity, like my ego removal has been such a big part of the last few years of my life that my identity to me has become far less important. Mm-hmm. But of course, it's a background, right? And and I will say that before I go into it a little bit, man, I'm mirrored on your thoughts. This has been, I'm so grateful for everything. Okay, like it's the similarities and the similarities in all of us, the stories, the same underlying souls we have are so aligned, it's unbelievable. And the most surreal thing is it took, like we said, this little turquoise blue hole in the middle of the ocean to bring us together.
Yes.
And we've all found this underlying share of the same beliefs. And it's incredible. Incredible. So a little background about myself. I've traveled the world a lot, mainly from having a crazy family who's brought me up all over the world, which has been really cool. For the last 15 years, I was in professional motorsport. And since then, that's coming to an end, and now I'm looking really for what I can give back to the world. You know, motorsport can be an incredibly ego-driven, selfish industry with vast amounts of expenses being paid. I'm not talking it down in any way. I love it.
I love it,
and I have a lot of passion for it, but for me personally, it wasn't doing enough for what I believe my true potential is during this time I'm on this simulation or wherever we are, you know? So I wanted to do something different. I have a big background in reggae music in the Caribbean. I listened to the words of Bob Marley a lot. He really resonated with me as a young child. And there's a lot of crazy coincidences whereby, you know, the house he used to live in was the same name as my mother and all this stuff. I lost my mother very young, so that was quite a hard thing to stomach, but that really forced me to look within. And when you look within, it's an incredible journey. You don't really know where it's going to take you. And I started looking within through the power of plants. You know, that was my big thing. So I explored a lot of plant journeys. And ultimately, like I mentioned before, it removed my ego, but it also taught me just how powerful we as humans can be, you know, and what kind of a difference we can make, and more people need to realize that. And I'm incredibly grateful to have spent this last week with some really powerful, influential people. And what excites me the most, UK, is some of these guys, you know, I've been alive for 39 years. Now, these guys are a lot younger than me, and it's really encouraging to put time and energy into these people, because these people are going to be the people that are going to be shaping my children. You know, my children, my eldest child is 11 years old, and had to have the likes of Sam, Zach, Gus, Jacob, all these powerful people, creative geniuses, you know, who really get it at that age, is really encouraging for where this life can potentially go. And if something's not done soon, the life that we knew is not going to be enjoyed by our children. If we do it right, the life that we knew is going to be even exemplified by our children, and they can even make it a better place, right? And that's the aim. That's the aim, is to try and leave the planet in a better shape than where we had it.
So. Right.
So that really is a bit of background between Uprising. Now, Uprising itself is a movement. It's a revolt against an established system. And too many people fall into that established system, you know, and I see too many people depressed. I see too many people suffer mental health. I see too many people not really in touch with their true soul and not true to their true identity. And that can cause a lot of problems. Now, you strip away those surface ego layers and you find an underlying common oneness in everything and all living things, in my opinion. And that is basically the fundamental background to the Uprising movement. You know, it's what can we achieve as a movement to showcase how beautiful the world is and to give back as best we can. And it just so happens that we've discovered this playground that's previously untouched, which is the sky. And the sky is beautiful, man.
Yes.
And we can do some really beautiful things in the sky. And I think people will start to take notice once we really begin to get this movement off the ground, you know.
Yeah.
And that's how we will get our message across. And then by giving back, we've got all sorts of cool things planned with Jokke in the future. So keep tuned, guys, because there's going to be some mega stuff coming. even already, we've got some crazy.
It's going to be so much good stuff. And now that you know a little bit of, you know, Nick's mindset here, that was for me, you know, like to meet someone as powerful and resourceful as yourself with that mindset. for me, it's like, I never thought this day was going to come, you know? Mm. I was like, and especially after, since I got into ayahuasca and other psychedelics, I've been really like going deep in my own mind to search for like what would truly make me happy in the future. Because I mean, I've had fun for 11 years, you know, or pretty much my whole life, I just had fun. And now like, we can keep having fun, but if we're just having fun for ourselves, we're not gonna find fulfillment in the long
100%.
run.
100%, ego doesn't offer fulfillment, does it, really?
So we need to give back to people, to the world and to nature, and to actually try and change, even though like our reality is so already, you know, on the edge of like, okay, we are doing a lot of carbon, spewing carbon and doing all these things. But I think there is a lot of good things we can do with the sports we're doing, 100%. With the art of what we're doing, you know?
100%. 100%, and make it accessible to everybody, and really unlock yourself, because, you know, skydiving and flow state is an incredibly interesting concept. Because if everybody could hit a flow state, and I'm not saying they need to skydive to do it, but they need to look within to do it. Yeah. If everybody would hit the flow state of being at one with everybody else, the world would be a much better place.
Yeah.
There's no guarantee. 100%. No one can say that. The 100%. Hate would go, the anger, the resentments, the jealousy, all the superficial stuff that we suffer as problems today. Not to mention the impact that's having on the climate and the environment we live in. Mm. Both equally important, that we need to make a difference. So for our part, you know, we've started small. We've started on this small movement. We've had this great thing. You know, the blue hole is very symbolic for me because it looks like an evil eye to me. It looks like an evil eye which wards away the spirits. And we like jumped into it and baptized it. Three times we were cleansed, you know? Yeah. But everyone came out with a massive smile on their face and a rejuvenated energy, and people are going back now. The kids, I call them the kids, but they're, you know, some really talented young souls that have been on this trip. They're going to create some magic with it, and me and Yuki are going to be, along with Alex and a bunch of others, really joining. And I'm very grateful that you're allowing us to join on your journey.
Oh, right? Man.
Because it's amazing how similar things are. And it's a missing piece that we needed, and now we're going to tag along to that and do some really cool stuff.
It's going
to
be amazing. What this team is going to create in the future is going to be so beautiful to watch. Mm-hmm. And I really love the fact that, like, at the end of the day, it was the DMT and the ayahuasca and everything that kind of put me on this path. Mm-hmm. And then it kind of connects the dots with others that had the same experience, and you know, it's just so
100%.
Cool, you know?
It was, for me, it was the 5-MeO. That was huge. I did a recent journey, and it was so big. The visual, it really fundamentally stripped away all the surface egos that I had, even in so much as going back to generations of family, and it showed me how powerful I could be in the future, and what difference I could make, and that automatically fit in. Like the first people we meet after that is you and Alex. Like, it's crazy. And everything I was told was going to happen is happening.
Wow, you know? it's so fascinating. We're gonna take you, audience, through some of these ceremonies, because obviously
we're gonna explore a lot of
we're gonna do more psychedelics, and I'm definitely gonna do some of it on camera for you guys to see, and also to explain a little bit more about it, you know. But we can go more in detail of that later on in the vlog, because those subjects we need to dedicate multiple episodes.
I think
they
need a lot of individual time, because it's incredibly powerful. And I think hopefully we can showcase that through our own journey and our own experiences. You guys will be able to relate, because I personally feel it's incredibly powerful. You know, there's been some big movements over the years, but I've got a lot of energy into this one, and I really can see the potential of it.
And can you imagine if everyone did it? The whole world did it today. Like ten sessions.
Presidents and prime ministers have all experienced the same thing. Yeah. The world. That's
or maybe you're gonna be the future president,
or you, bro. But then we know. Then we know.
It's good.
So yeah, guys, keep tuned.
Yes,
some really exciting stuff.
Thank you again, Nick, for making this
trip
happen.
Anytime, brother. Wait
for you to just pop into my life like that. That's
likewise,
amazing.
Bro. Likewise.
That's amazing.
Gonna be epic, man.
Yes. Okay, guys. I hope you enjoyed this amazing trip to Belize and Panama, and give a special thanks to him for that.